Now we are discussing about motion of a spinning ball. For example, in the cricket, for spinning ball, if you observe, what happens? It is moving linearly, simultaneously it is having rotation. So, if r is the radius of that ball, if it is rotating with omega angular velocity, it is possessing some v dash velocity. What is the v dash velocity? R omega. R is the radius of the ball and omega is the angular velocity. So, due to that, in the downward, v minus v dash creating, there is a net velocity. In the top, v plus v dash creating. So, velocity is variation capable. Here less velocity, here more velocity. Actually, if it is goes along straight path without rotation, no problem. Same velocity only. But due to this rotation, here v dash velocity changing the top and bottom velocities. Here less velocity, here more velocity. So, if less and more velocity is creating, according to Bernoulli's theorem, if velocity is less, definitely pressure more. So, due to that, what happens? Upward some force exerting. That is a dynamic lift. Simultaneously, it is dragging. Due to this, different velocities in the top and bottom, that is called Magnus effect. It is called Magnus effect. So, due to this Magnus effect, dragging. Ball dragging. Due to air is dragging that ball due to Magnus effect. This is called Magnus effect. Okay, now I am applying Bernoulli's theorem. According to Bernoulli's theorem, what is the formula? P by rho plus GH plus V square by 2 equal to constant. Otherwise, you apply P plus rho Gs plus V square by 2. This is pressure energy plus potential energy plus kinetic energy per unit mass. Otherwise, P plus rho Gs plus rho V square by 2. That is pressure energy, potential energy, kinetic energy per unit volume. Anything you take. At any area of cross section. That is called Bernoulli's theorem. For example, this is my ground. From this ground, this top, this bottom I am taking H1-8 and this top I am taking H2-8. Here H1 approximately equal to H2. One ball is moving from this side, from the ground, this side H1 and this side H2. But the thickness is very small. Compared to this big height, this side small thickness. So H1 approximately H2. So in this case, H1 approximately H2. So H1, H2 equal. So you write that. Then what happens here? P1 by rho 1 plus GH1. Plus V1 square by 2, that equal to P2 by rho 2 plus GH2 plus V2 square by 2. H1, H2 approximately equal. So, this cancel. Now, what are the remaining things? What is the rho 1, rho 2 density? Here and there, top and bottom air same only. So, density of the air same. So, you write it as P1 by rho plus V1 square by 2, that equal to P2 by rho plus V2 square by 2. That's all. So, by using that equation, what is the pressure difference? By using that surface area of that ball, pressure into surface area. That gives what force? How much force? Dynamic lift. Upward force exerting, that force is called dynamic lift. The aerodynamic lift, how we had found, same like that only, here also we are finding. First we are finding P1 minus P2. By taking V1 square that side, again, force equal to pressure into area. P1 minus P2 into area. How much surface area added? That's all. So, in that way, we are getting aerodynamic lift. Here, what happens extra? Dragging occurs. Not only dynamic lift. In the case of aeroplane wing, only dynamic lift. But in this case, dynamic lift and also dragging. Due to this condition, dynamic lift. But due to this Magnus effect, dragging. What is the Magnus effect? Velocity is different creating due to dragging of the air molecules, surface air molecules, bottom air molecules dragging due to some rough surface of the ball, it is dragging the air molecules. Due to the dragging effect, it is changing the direction. So, this is happening in the case of, that is called Magnus effect. So, this is about spinning ball.